Hello everyone and welcome back to Dragalia Lost. So today I expected to do a gacha video, however it seems like the banner will come on Wednesday, so we might have to delay that and just get into the event and show a bit of it like I did for the Linnea and Nadine United Front. This time I want to do a bit of a talking video rather than something explaining the event or tell you about it, because the event is kinda similar in some of its structure to the Linnea and Nadine United Front. I did a really in-depth analysis video of that event and what I felt was good and what I felt was bad. So this time I want to do something that is more exploring what this event does, what was improved, and what I feel is the idea behind those events going into the future. So this time it is Shadow, to my dismay, because I really have a good roster of Shadow Element characters, so I also have a hard time deciding which character to use. I will show you my team for this event, which I built especially for this event with Custom Wyrm Prince, and also a setup that is kinda different from usual. As you see, we have Xena, we have Linnea, we have Sharina, and we have Peony. So why did I decide to not use my optimal team? Because I don't need to. Why would you need to use an optimal team for an event like this that only lasts a week and is meant for you guys to enjoy the gameplay of the game a bit more? Try to use adventurers that you never used before. Adventurers like Sharina, for example, who have a bonus when you use them on those type of maps, I think she does, if I'm not wrong. No, it is Alphonse who has a bonus, so I'm wrong on that, but you know what I mean. Use Wyrm Prince like the Heroes Arrive, who have Slayer Strength, which in this event is really useful. Use dragons that you never use. Use a combo that you never thought it would work on this type of events. There are many considerations that you will make about those type of events. So we will play with co-op, because I want you guys to show you how it works on co-op first, because last time we didn't have co-op on this type of map, we had it on the second map of FPA Part 2. So the map is mostly the same like FPA Part 1, they already said that they are planning to add more maps in the future. I think this is mostly because of COVID, they didn't manage to make a map in time, because if I understand the Dragalia devs correctly, they have multiple tasks at hand, and their main job is to work for the big events at the end of the month. So we will see what that event will be. I will tell you more about it later. So this is the map. I already opened it earlier. A little bit of tips before we get into it for new players and for players who have never seen the FA Part 1 map. So you start right here, and what you want to do at start is have those two paths covered, so that the units that come from here, and from, I think it is like this, you manage to destroy them. After that, you will have three bandits that spawn, one here, and one here. You want two of your teammates, one to go here, and one to do this. And you want also to lower this bridge, and also this one. So when you destroy this bandit, you will unlock the minimap, and it will tell you where the enemies are coming from, which you can see right down here. When playing defensive battles on Master difficulty, this one, enemy location won't be displayed on the map until you visit a specific house, which is the one right here on the bottom right, this one. After that, you have the final wave. You will have two mages and two fiends that spawn. You want to kill the fiends because they deal a lot of damage to the gate, and be wary of the mage attack because they can chase you over all the map. After that, you get into the final boss fight, and there is also a bonus enemy that will spawn right here. So make sure to kill that bonus enemy for bonus glory before you get into the final boss fight, which in this case will be Valix, so we will see how that goes. So you can see here, draw bridges, you lower them by attacking this thing right here, this small mechanism. You have houses that when you save them you get a bonus and also a buff. And now we will check it out. So, I hope you didn't mind that small introduction. I like to make small guides for new players or for veterans if they need them. But now let's get into the meaty part of the event. So we have Abellina and Alphonse, Aluga. I will function as healer because if you don't know, Xena can heal thanks to her special ability. It's not, of course, one of the most amazing heals ever, but it can work for anything. So let's talk a bit about the event. The event is meant to be a defensive event, the first one we had outside of a collab. And those type of events don't have a fixed element to it when we go into the defensive part. The previous parts do have an element, which are Shadow and Light, as I said earlier. So, as you can see, it brings about some sort of customization of your own experience. Now, as you can see, the map is quite huge. You will see it coming on the top right there. What you want to do... Shady lower the bridge. It's not the best pick you can do at start. It seems like I will have to cover the base because you want to be wary of where the enemies come from at all times. But it seems like they did add the extra speed that you get when you do this event. On the first FA, it wasn't there, which made it quite hard, I must say. So I'm using also the latest Gala Dragon, which is Kate Sith. She's really good for all type of content, as Gala Dragon social B, because they are indeed limited. And so far it's going good, no enemies got to the castle. I like the fact that I can see the enemies as of now, because it means that I have to kinda strategize behind this event, or this fact, I should say. Okay, so you can see we unlocked the enemies on the minimap. This should make it a lot easier to strategize. Make sure to unlock... Oh, wow! That's a big wave of enemies going for the castle. I like that. They changed the waves. It wasn't like this in the original event, before you just had to cover those two fronts. I like that. So there is some sort of change in the map structure as far as enemy goes. Let's heal. And now we have to do those single type enemies. Wow, I got the wrong way there. Maybe they are mad at me for not getting the fiend. Oh, that's a chimera, I think. No, a manticore, sorry. We didn't have manticores before, we just had Cyclops. That's nice, I can see that they did put some sort of changes into the map. Not to the layout of the map, because it's the same. I kinda wanted to have a summary in the map, but I guess it's fine. Because, guys, let me preface you this. I do feel that at the end of the month we will get a true summary event. That's not something that you guys should think that is just a guess. Because next week we will be getting the rerun of the summer Estelle event. If you never... Did it is a really good event. I liked it a lot back when it released. It will have a banner with Summer Celiera and Summer Giulietta as a rerun. And after that we will likely get Master Kayan on the week after, which should be the week of the 27th. And on Wednesday, when usually raid events end, because they last 10 days or so, we should get the Summer event, the new one. It will be the premium event of the month, if you will, the one with the new songs, the new maps, etc. And also it will have new characters and a Gala banner to go with it. It will likely be Gala Laxi, no doubt about that. She will be Water, because Water is the only element with one Gala, I think. And also some other swimsuit characters. Hopefully, if it is a meme, I manage to pull her. I am saving up a lot for the Gala banner. As you can see, I have 10,000 Wyrmites. I also have a ton of tickets that I will use Wednesday to get Pasha and Mikoto, hopefully. Ooh, we have a defensive battle axe. Let's do this one while I talk about more stuff. And hopefully you guys join me on Wednesday if we manage to get them some exciting new summer stories. We also have all the summer stories for all the summer adventures released so far. We just need the... I wonder why everyone is going fire. Maybe I'm missing something here. We have all the summer stories. If you want to enjoy them, are on the channel. I will have to cover the summer event story itself. Hopefully I don't forget. I still need to do the Dream Under the Big Top rerun story. I didn't do yet. But I guess I can save it. It is there forever, so not really in a rush to do it. And what else is there to say? So let's talk a bit about the stuff that is most polarizing. So as you know, this event doesn't give a ton of Wyrmite rewards, kinda like the Linnea and Nadine event did. So back then, what I had to say about that it was fine if the event just lasted 1 week and we still get a rerun after that. We did indeed get a rerun in the form of the Halloween event. So the Wyrmite count for June was mostly the same, if not a little bit higher, thanks to the rewards from this type of event. So what does this mean for the future? It means that the defensive and onslaught events will be a smaller scale event that probably aim to give us more material type of rewards rather than Wyrmites and such. Which to me is fine, probably more than fine, because usually, like for example, we don't get tomes for free. Tomes are the new material that you use to unlock the skillshare system. Not getting them for free means that those type of events are needed, because we kinda need a way to get them for free for players that can't or don't want to spend. If those come only from those events, they kinda get a role in the free-to-play experience, which is fine. Also, you have to consider that those events run only for a week, and they replace previously dead weeks. Like, back when the game released, we had dead weeks. And back when we had dead weeks, people logged on just to do dailies, and after they did the dailies, they said, well, I'm done. Nothing more to do. This Edselit kinda blundered. And how do I feel about that? Personally, I prefer when the game gives me content to do, like this. Right now I am playing the game, I am giving time to the game more than I would do if the game was only about daily logins. So I feel like it is good and fine to do this type of events. The last 1 week, they don't take anything away from us, like they don't take resources, because the VA, the events itself is really simple. They don't take away Wyrmites, because they give us extra Wyrmites thanks to this event. Like, consider that we get also an event compendium rerun every time we get those type of events. That guy went to the finale for no reason, I guess. It's fine. Okay, here we have Valix. I wonder if he's different compared to the usual boss. He does seem to spam the usual things. I think he has the same mechanics from the story fight. He seems to be a little bit smaller, if I am honest with you. Okay, let's use Kate's hit here. Should be easy enough. I wonder why his name is Imperial Panok. I was targeting another enemy. Okay. So here we are. Quite easy. We got a blunder with the Red Slit. I wonder why she died. And I wonder why the guy went to the finale straight away. I guess it is players who don't know about the extra enemy. Which is why I'm here to inform you that don't rush to the finale. You need to destroy the final enemy to get a ton of extra might. Like, I wonder if I can show you. No, I skipped it, of course, because I am dumb as well. Ooh, okay. Now, let me tell you this. So, back when we had the Linnea and Nadine first event, one of the general complaints was that we didn't have any champion testaments. I can say that they listened to that feedback and they gave us at least two of them, because I saw that there is one in the shop and we just got one, so there is two. Let's see if there is another one in the glory one. There isn't. And let's see if I buy this one, if another one spawns. No. Okay, so it is two. Which makes sense, because we get two new adventurers. So they listen to the complaint of the Champion Testament. They listen to the complaint of the glory rewards. We got a ton more of glory out of EX quest and also out of general quest. You didn't need to repeat any quest to get to the master difficulty. What they didn't listen to is the reward structure, which I said earlier is fine because it is extra Wyrmites, it is not Wyrmites that was taken from us. We get about 14 pulls out of this event, plus the 20 or so tickets that you get from the event compendium, which we got the ant from Harmony, plus the Wyrmites that you also get from all the quests and stuff from the event compendium quest, and also the tickets. There is a ton of free stuff, guys, like, we can't complain about that. The game needs a player to spend, and free-to-player players like me, if we want this game to stay alive, to keep things coming, we need to support it some way. I try to buy when I can some packs, the probably most reasonable ones, because I still think they need to fix the prices on some packs, they are kinda way too high. And this event, of course, isn't outside of criticism, I'm not saying that, but don't bash this event, guys. This event is good for the game, it is good for you because it gives you a reason to log in and play, which is what you want a game to do. You want to play a game, not to basically be a gambling simulator. Like, the gacha in this game is so well implemented. They fixed the weird print issue, they fixed the fact that we had banners with low rates, and they gave us 2 galas a month, which is good because they implemented the event banner into the gala, which made them better. Like, they still have issue with dragons breaking PT rate and with not having sparking system. However, I just feel bad for the devs of this game, like, getting so much negativity from those type of events when they are clearly meant to give us something to do during a week that otherwise would be dead. I don't really enjoy that kind of criticism. There are a ton of other gacha games in this channel as well that do things way, way worse. Like, I am a FGO player, I love FGO, but sometimes we get dead weeks, sometimes we get rerun of old events that last half a month and give us, like, not even alpha 10 pull. We have games like Seven Deadly Sins, Grand Cross, we give us banners back to back with low odds, sometimes they change stuff. Like, there are way worse gacha games with way worse strategies behind them than this game. And I don't understand the criticism behind the rewards, behind the fact that this event doesn't have stuff, etc. Like, if you want to criticize stuff, criticize the fact that we don't have the auto feature for the defensive battles. That's something that makes sense to have, for example, at least for master or lower difficulties. Criticize the fact that they didn't release the banner on the events day, which I will get into this in a bit, but I will. Or criticize the fact that the event itself doesn't have voice acting. You can criticize that, don't criticize the fact that the rewards are bad, or that the event is bare bones. Like, that doesn't make sense. The event is meant to be bare bones, it lasts a week, it's meant to bridge the gap between the two, the event and the rerun, and then the successive event. It's not meant to be the new event of the month, it is not the summer event of this game, like, it isn't. Like, we get a new event at the end of the month every month, we always do, and the end of the month event will likely be the new summer event. If it isn't, I won't mind, because it is also a new event, but I feel like it will be. It will likely be wind, and it will be with a new gala, which means that you have more chances to get the new events. So, that's what I have to say about it. Which, to recap, if you have feedback, good feedback for this event, use the feature that they gave you to send them feedback. They listened, they did listen for the past event, they did fix stuff, and they don't deserve the negativity. Do it in a friendly and comprehensive way. Remember that the people that work for us for this game, if you don't pay and if you just play for this, they're basically doing it not for free, but about for free, let's say, like that. The game revenue isn't of the best, so I really want this game to be alive, and I am fine if they are kinda teasing the player base a bit to try and make some money out of their banners. I think it is fine since the game is free, since they gave us a ton of free stuff every month. I feel like the game needs to survive. And that's all I have to say about it. This video kinda turned about a rant rather than a guide about the event, but that's fine. Anyway, so this is it for the gameplay showcase of this event and also the talk that we just had. So let's talk about the schedule for this month. So we have this event, we have the banner Wednesday, we have the rerun of the Summer Estelle on Monday, we will have likely the rerun of her banner on also Wednesday when this banner ends, the Summertime Savior banner ends. I will do a Should You Pull on that banner when it comes out, like I did for the Halloween banner. After that we will have the new event coming likely on the Wednesday after, since raid reruns usually last 10 days. Alongside it will come the new Gala banner, which I will of course cover. On the Monday of that month, of that week, we will likely get Master Kayan and maybe the interludes. Those will come to the channel of course. And hopefully you guys find this month interesting, like we had June, which was more interesting than I expected it to be. And thank you very much for joining me. Sorry for the rant if you didn't enjoy it. If you did, leave the feedback and what is your opinion below. I like to listen to different opinions to give my perspective on what you say and or to answer to your criticism. And if you enjoyed the video, I hope that you leave a like and a sub for future content on the channel. Anyway, this is it for today. Hunter Lodge is out and have a good summer defensive battle event.